This is Scott Spears, and today we're on location in Easton, Ohio, at the Hilton Hotel, joined by a legendary comedian. In my opinion, one of the most legendary comedians of all time, and a man who's been on radio with us so many times, and we always appreciate his visit because it makes us think, and he was just with us yesterday, which is always a thrill. Playing the funny bone in here in Easton, Ohio, it is my pleasure to introduce Dick Gregory. Mr. Gregory?
Thank you. Let me just say this to you. People probably don't appreciate you because they don't know where America is. Let me introduce myself as this, and I'll say it twice in case y'all one of these chicken shit churches that can't say nigger, okay? See, I don't respect that because not one black person was sitting in the room when that decision was made. Did you hear what I just said?
I did.
That was white folks that made that decision. And let me tell you how it won. If I walk out there and a white dude called me a nigger and hit me, that's a hate crime. He called me N-word and hit me, that's not a hate crime. And that's what these black folks let them bullshit us and take us through. Now let me say it over again. The N-word, which I detest. But if I was sitting outside, someone called me the N-word and hit me, that's a hate crime. If they call me the N-word and hit me, what day will the Jews be silly enough to let the Germans say, we're no longer going to call it a concentration camp, it's the C-word. Okay, we're no longer going to call it what it is. And that's where this is. But it's over now, and let me say this, then we get to your questions. One of my granddaughters came to me, 6 years old, and said, I've been Googling you all year. Oh, granddad, there's so much stuff about you that you say. She said, when you look in the mirror, my granddaughter, what do you see when you look at you? You know more about you than the people who write about you. I said, I see a nigger-hating, redneck cracker. She said, no, that's who I am. And I don't want no white folks to tell me that ain't what you are. The difference between me and you and the rest of them, I know what I am. Every time I get on a plane and go to Budapest and pay $42,000 round trip plus taxes, I'm financing everything this wench do. All the bums they drop on babies around the world. So when they fall on my grandchildren, I won't be surprised. But you all will. Every time your wife go and buy a gallon of milk, she financed this crap. And the Germans didn't know that when the universe came down and wiped them all out. Okay? All you got to do is feel something. America then dropped 2 nuclear bombs. We build nuclear bombs. Nuclear submarines is built in Groton, Connecticut, all over the world, and we pay for it. So now watch this now. We go to Vietnam, we go to Iraq, they ain't got no Harvards, they ain't got no World Banks, and they kick our ass. And you can't see that's another hand? You hear me?
I do.
Then we come back with all our money and research, and as we sit here today, because NBC and them is lying, 75 veterans have committed suicide today, yesterday, and the day before. Okay? Now, if we committing suicide with all the technology, what are they doing in Iraq and Vietnam? Nothing, because if there was, they'd be telling us about it. And so there's another order, and that's where you are, and you got to remember that. That's where you are. I mean, people worry about, especially a lot of black folk, about losing their job. I ain't never cared about that. I spend more money for the movement, because this was the movement. Black folks made me. And there's a universal God. And so now, finally, let me say this. I'm going to talk to my grandmother now because she has no education. She has no money. Grandma, you look at NBC and CBS and all that crap where they debating black-on-black crime. Let me tell you something. If the Germans would have been killing Germans, it wouldn't have made no big news. It's something about family. I can leave my house and pat my wife on the butt and say, see you later, baby, but I can't do you like that. Same act, two different circumstances. The mob have killed Italians 24 hours a day. They killed judges, huh? Police chiefs. They kill Italian, and nobody say Italian on Italian crime. Now, let me tell you what I'm going with this here. Somewhere, Grandma, I'm talking to you now. Put on a pot of water and let the universe tell you, because you don't have the technology or the education to figure it out. Put on a pot of water and put that old tea kettle on. And put a top on the pot and just sit back in the rocking chair. And when you hear that tea kettle go, that's the universe telling you I'm fixing to blow. That's what the universe been telling America, but you black folks and you white folks don't hear it. Huh? You gonna sit and debate while that pot is giving you a warning, you gonna debate. You go to the movie, I smell something like smoke. What have you ever smelt like smoke that wasn't smoke? Huh? Okay, see, we as black folks know if them cops had been killing dogs, white folks would burn down the police. We know that, but we don't talk about you. You're not close enough to know how we feel about you and your goddamn dogs. Huh? We look at you. Hire a black nanny to change your baby diaper, but walk your own dog and pick up the dog shit. You think we don't know who you are? I'm not talking about you. Huh? When Nelson Rockefeller, see, we know everything because we was the maids. We can work in houses that white folk can't work in, okay? So we here. My mother's mother worked for Frank and Jesse James up in the Boot Hill. So they know, we know when Jesse got killed, Frank changed his name to Rockefeller and moved east with them. We know stuff that y'all don't know, okay? Y'all think y'all know something because that old supremacy stuff. White ain't a color, it's an attitude. And if you haven't got trillions of dollars in the bank, you can't have the attitude. So I tell black folks and most white, you ain't never seen a white person in your life. If you ain't got trillions of dollars, you're not white. That $1 million stuff, you take $1 million and change it to 1 million seconds. That's 13 days. You take $1 billion and change it to second. That's 32 years. Who want to be a millionaire but some poor, ignorant white or black? This is what the game is, huh? You go to these raggedy schools. Do you know the real super white folks on the planet wouldn't send a dog to Harvard and Yale? Do you realize we the only country in the world got a good school and a bad school? Huh? And finally, when you put that top on and ignore it, when you hear the baby crying but you so busy trying to get your lottery numbers in, and then you go in and the baby dead. The baby was choking to death. I'm gonna call mom and dad. That's what y'all hear now. So you white folk can play all your games. You can bring all them Negroes in with you to talk that stuff with you. It's over. When a woman's 9 months pregnant is over, the baby gonna fall if it means death to the mother and the child. Count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 holes. 8, 9. 9 holes in my body. The number of God is 9. And there's 9 planets that run the universe. Okay? And you ain't going to trick this one. Only niceness and kindness. But I think we're too late. We're going beyond the point of no return. And so this is where we are. And that's why you're important. Somebody out there might hear you. Here. Right here. I just transferred $50 million today. Now, let me tell you how the universe works. If you got $10 million in the bank, and the bank could close next week, okay? All they pay you is $250,000, okay? But my son was the financial analyst for the city of New York that had trillions of dollars in the bank, and there's a system you call where they break it down so you don't lose nothing. It's my son, okay? That's what I got. So I'm calling people that I know, huh? That I know, so they don't have to lose it, okay? And what they do with the computers, if you had $30 million in the bank, they put your number in, and that thing breaks it down to banks all over the world, so there's no more money in there than $250,000. That's what this is about. Ain't no such thing as who's rich and who's this and who's that, huh? Ain't no such thing as so-and-so's good and so-and-so's bad, huh? When Nelson Rockefeller decided he gonna run for president of the United States, he had a gay son, Michael. Back then, that's a no-no. So Nelson Rockefeller, his daddy, sent him to New Guinea on a business trip, and the cannibals ate him. Okay? And you move your head. You ain't white. Real white folks that know what they do. That's how they get to where they're going. Okay? I looked at the president 6 months ago sign a $80 billion piece of paper to buy the new jet. But I turned on the radio and turned on TV, and what do I hear? Begging to send money in for the veterans. And y'all stupid enough to go. Send money in for the vet. They don't beg for bum money. This is what America is. A piece of doo-doo. God bless America. Hitler and them said that. And let me tell you something about Christianity. If you want to find the best documented on Christianity, you got to go to Germany. Germany has more Christian documents. They come from all over the world to study there. And look what it produced. This is a game. And so when we sit around and we look and we see, huh? If them would have been dogs they was killing, white folks would have lost appetite. We check all the major restaurants and they didn't have no cancellations the other day.
With everything that's going on, with everything that's happened in Dallas and everything that's went around the country the last week, the Republican convention coming up, they've got people in the harbor, they're in Cleveland, you've transferred money. Is this the tea kettle at a fever pitch right now?
No, it's not there yet. It's on its way there. No, you're going to suffer on this one. And me too. Huh? Out of all the nasty stuff we've done. But see, let me tell you how it really, the fever pitch hit. A black man become president. Can you white and black folk be so stupid to know the racism in this country? There's no way a black man could have been elected president. Let me tell you how it works. Black folks, I can't speak for white folk because I don't know them that well. Black folks have had a headache for 40 years. And then one day they get an examination and find out it's a brain tumor. That's America. This wench have had a brain tumor for over 100 years. Here's how the God talks to you. A black woman just got her picture on the front page, front of a $20 bill. The reason you know that black folk didn't have nothing to do with that. Because had we had something to do with it, we'd have lightened her up and fixed her up so she looked like she just finished Harvard. These young white folks that had something to do with it, say, let's show the world what a slave woman looked like. But more important than that, is the front of the $20 bill before her picture's gonna go on was President Jackson. He's a slave owner. Now, here's how the real God worked. Replace the president with a slave. That's what happened. Most folks don't even know that. They didn't even see that. Huh? Go back and look at her. Look at her. Look what this country has made of me because I didn't stoop to hatred. I'm talking about me, Dick Gregory. Nobody on the planet has ever gone through what black folks have gone through during slavery. And yet the real white folks hire us to take care of their babies, watch their children. Ignorant white folks are scared as me, because when you look at me, you see your filth. When you look at me, you see your filth. I ain't never been a mobster. I ain't never brought drugs in, huh? Black on black crime, that's your excuse, huh? People have always, Romans kill Romans. Y'all didn't put no tune to it. Okay, now watch this now. Watch it. You have the electric chair. Now I'm talking to all you white folks out there and all you silly Negroes that think you white. I'm gonna give you something that ain't too hard for you to figure out, okay? If my trifling cousin, and y'all got some too, don't act like you haven't, came to Columbus today and came out to this beautiful area where we are and walked into the Hilton Hotel, my cousin, and killed 20 white folks, he gonna get the electric chair. If he did it in Washington, D.C., huh? They'd move it, because Washington, D.C. don't have electricity. They'd move it across the line to Virginia. Now, I want y'all to hear this good, especially you folks that think you white. If Prince Charles's drug addict son came here and killed 1,000 white folks, you know he ain't going to get the electric chair, but you can't deal with that because you want to believe you're free. You want to believe you white. Do I have to say this again? Huh? Do I have to say this again? And when y'all look in that mirror and start seeing a nigger-hating redneck quacker like I do, you might start figuring out stuff. You might start figuring out stuff. But you can't, because you're locked up in this bullshit. Oh, we're going to have this for the cops. We're going to have this. See, the great thing about King, you didn't need nothing, because King would have been there with that love and that peace and the kindness. Y'all sit around and you pick your stars. Mahatma Gandhi, he's a pedophile, man. And all you gotta do is check the records. He wasn't born in India. In 1904, he led an army. Y'all don't even know that, huh? They give you whatever they wanna give you and you buy it. So here's a man came, my Obama, me and Kathy Hughes. Talked to an FBI agent 15 years before he'd been president. And he says, it's going to be a black man. It's going to be president. He's going to try. So people think I'm a problem. So before all this happened, when I said he'll win by a landslide, and he'll win the second one by a landslide. So all my research friends around the world said, you don't ever see nothing bad about Obama. Why, you know who he is. I say, well, the first time he run, we're one rifle crazy. And you heard him saying, you'll be a one-term president. You'll be a one-term president. You'll be a one-term president. He went crazy. Second time he run, they mad now. The only way you deal with a mad dog is kill it. There's no medicine. So y'all sitting out there that think this is just a feeling. You see, 300 years ago, the American government sent the scientists, linguist scientists, to there, to Columbia, to study hieroglyphics. And said, after, we can't break it down now, but we will break it down. 150 years later, they broke it down. Here's what it said. White man, one day, the white lady gonna do the same thing to your children you doing to ours. And 300 years ago, cocaine wasn't called the white lady. See, when you're supreme, you don't have to call yourself supreme. At all. And I looked at the Pope here, had sciatica so bad, He couldn't hardly walk, and I want him to wash my feet. I'm the one that did the research, and all I got to do is check it. Them folks in South America think the Pope, but Pope was born in a village outside of Italy. Okay? That's how long they planned. They sent him over there. And if you ever get the courage to punch up the dirty Pope, his name comes up. Okay? And if you look back on your computer, especially you thugs out there listening, here's what you'll find. February the 2nd, 2012, the Bank of Italy suspended all Vatican credit cards. Did y'all know that? Because they was laundering drug money. They was laundering little girls and laundering little boys. Shut them down. Okay, now you don't have to take this from nigger Greg. You dealing with something bigger than me. Now watch this now. So, Sweden. Can you wife be stupid enough to believe that Sweden don't have no army? No soldiers? But all the dirty people in the world put their money in Swiss banks. They got something over there we don't know about. You don't have to be smart to figure that out. So they went and got the money they needed from Swiss banks at a horrible price. That's what this is about. That's what this is about. And so when you look at, you know, what's going on, and listen to the shows, man. Listen to that bullshit. You hear NBC, CBS, Dan Rather. He's a punk reporter when Kennedy got shot. Worked at a radio newspaper 30 miles outside of Dallas. So when they come up with the Saputo film, which showed some stuff they didn't mean for it to show. Well, they said, well, this will just really devastating for the Kennedy family, so we'll get a pool reporter to review it. And he'll tell the world if he saw anything. Otherwise, we're going to. So he lied, and they moved him all the way up to the anchor. He's part of the filth, okay? One of my good personal friends, man. One of my good personal friends. And we talked every day, man. And he went in and did 5 interviews. Back to back with LBJ. And LBJ, up until this, I always thought LBJ had something to do with it. And LBJ said, I always thought Lee Harvey acted alone, but I realized it's a conspiracy. Now he said, I believe Lee Harvey Oswald, which he didn't. But I was shocked to hear him say that. And so now CBS is getting ready to run the 5-part series. So one of the garbage workers, black, who pick up every piece of paper they throw away and sell it. They ain't gonna sell it to Brother Greg. He called me and he says, hey man, the piece is gonna run next week and that part's deleted. Walter Cronkite with his thieving, ungodly self. Friends, so when I see him, and I said, man, why'd you take it out? He said, I didn't. CBS overruled me. I said, my ignorant grandma, don't turn it on. They turn it on to hear Uncle Walty, which was a piece of doo-doo. That's what this is about, man. So somewhere, what you put out there, I'm sure you don't do it every day. And I'm sure you got to worry about your rent, got to worry about this and that. You don't have to worry about no rent, man. The universe will take care of you. You don't have to worry about nothing at all. Let me show you something. What's your name, brother?
Terry.
What day are you born? Just the day, not the...
Tuesday.
I don't mean that. Just the date, not the day.
Oh, I'm sorry. September 28th.
28. So y'all know him, right?
Yes.
You're a good writer. You were the 28th, that's a one, that's the sun. So you've been going through changes in the last 6 months because the sun is number one and it's been exploding. Okay? And that's what you feel, and that's fixing to move out now. Now, y'all know him. Mm-hmm. I just met you today. Take you a long time to get mad, but when you get mad, everybody got to get out your way, including your children. It's about the numbers. And the white folks that run this planet don't do it with Harvard or Yale. They do it with the numbers, okay? September 28, what year? 1971. 71. Wow, Jesus, huh? Who in this room know you the best? You know how brilliant he is.
Yes.
And it didn't come from Harvard. It came from the universe. That's how brilliant you are. You do that with numbers, man. The people that run the world ain't never been to school. Huh? Queen Elizabeth make $360 million every 24 hours just interest on her money. You hear me? Queen Elizabeth. Queen Elizabeth can't go into London because London's not part of Britain. Here's an old nigger born. The only reason I wasn't on welfare, it wasn't invented when I know more about it than you white folk because y'all don't know nothing but what they feed y'all. Now all you got to do is go punch it up. All you got to do is go punch it up. And in order for Queen Elizabeth to go into London today, she got to get permission from the Lord Mayor. And if they give it to her, she got to come in the back gate, the temple gate, where they do the devil ritual, dressed as a servant. So whose queen is this? Huh? See how it works? And you black folks sitting down there, listen, you got a little punk comedian, Cedric the Entertainer. And you all go and look at the movie, Barbershop. It's filthy and you filthy. Here's what Cedric said on the first one. Martin Luther King ain't nothing but a whore. And Rosa Parks didn't do nothing. She's just too tired to move her big, fat, black ass. Now, why you know that came from a white boy? Rosa Parks ain't got a black ass. You hear me? So when you sit and look at this punk, said this about King. Oh, he went back to the White House. Nah, they don't pay no attention. This is Cedric, the entertainer, huh? A piece of garbage, huh? They into their third barbershop. Now, that don't mean nothing. Hmm? That don't mean a damn thing. Hmm? I got a grandson, got more money than that punk, and he just 11 years old, opened up a company when he was 5 years old, hacked $5,000 out of his daddy's account, put it back 2 years ago. This is what this is about. Why they got everybody preoccupied? Oh, I'm white, are you? Oh, so this is what this is about. And those out here is trying to change it, y'all don't even want to hear it because you got a racist mama, racist daddy, everybody you grew up with racist. But you call it something else. Pimps, filth of the planet, but they call them cool-ed. Cool Milton. Hmm? Their mama meets them when they come home with the Cadillacs, a big pot of money, and look the other way. That's over. That is over. See, probably one of the brilliant cats on the planet was the Romans. The Romans had they shit together. And then here a black man, Hannibal, come through with no army. He just went and recruited barbarians, ignorant white folks who don't mind dying. That's who he recruited. He had no army. Ignorant white folks. So then the white folks said, hey, wait a minute now. Let's do this, man. We got to put a limit to how ignorant we're going to let them become. That's where welfare come from. Wasn't for niggas. For you white folks. Huh? I can take a hoe all the way around the world tonight as long as I call them my secretary as a tax write-off. While y'all sitting around with your poor ass self talking this, and now the punishments come out. You rich, you know your children's going to Harvard, Yale, MIT. You didn't know they ended up now in community colleges. See how it works? Community college. Three PhDs and your daughter living in the basement of your house. That's what Trump is tuning into. Trump ain't got no money. This is money come from his daddy. How come you ain't seen no stories about his daddy? This is a game. This is a game. And the ones of you all white folks and black folks that break out of it, you the next controllers. Go out to the Silicon Valley. They're out there broke. 2 months, 2 years, they're billionaires. And so when you look at that white boy that put together JetBlue, but he didn't know too much about business. Became the number one airline on the planet. Now watch this now. Number one. Moved so fast they had to go on the stock market to borrow money to build the planes and stuff. No, but he didn't know. With his evening self. That now the people investors control the company. So he said, well, I'm not handling nobody from Harvard, Yale, MIT. He said, you ain't got nothing to say about it. He said, first, we're going to vote you off the board. You don't run the company no more. We do. Now, I'll show you what the genius is like. The genius is like. So he got, you know, $4 billion. Stop. Millions. So he went and opened up PayPal. See how it works? When you're solid. He opened up PayPal. See, the game. And so if you white folks listen to me, just go look into the mirror and see what a piece of shit you are, and then look next to you and see me. I'm the same. I'm the same. And I don't need to be cut no slack. My payoff is I found out who I was before I left here. Had a woman went to high school with me. I was in Spain. And she said, I'm over 400 pounds. She said, you the weight loss king. What I have to do? I said, just follow a hoe around. You ain't never seen a fat hoe. Think about that. I said, don't do what she do. Just eat what she eats. And you want to see fat women? Go to the Black Baptist Church sitting next to the choir. Then you know the Black Church got something, because they can't even get their shoes on right. And they just holler and jump, and they don't sweat. But now here's how the God talks to you. Black men is 4% of America's population, black men. We the only man on the planet, that call our wife, our woman strong, but call our car beautiful. No other man. Why do we call them strong? Because white, redneck, nigger hating crankers and convinced us if you don't look like a white lady, you can't be beautiful. We bought into it, but we see something. So we call it strong. Do you know a black woman in America is the only woman on the planet can take a butter knife and cut your ties to the rim? I'm one of the few that know that. That's why if you want to get me, you got to go through my wife. I make millions. I ain't never had a checking account in my life. All the money go to her. I got her pregnant. We didn't know nothing about no abortions. We didn't have to go to the pharmacist and they'll give you something to knock it out. I go back 3 months later, she's bigger than ever. Bigger than ever. I said, I didn't say I was gonna take it. So the baby came, Michelle. two PhDs from the London School of Economics in sex harassment at the workplace. So if she came to you to handle your case, they can't bring nobody in, because with white folks' bullshit, she's the only authority on the planet. See how it works? Just leave it alone. Leave it alone. Or can you get it out? Can you get it out of you? Can you get out? You know, we do not go and poison the tea. We do not go and poison the food. White folks leave us in charge of their children. That's what this is about. But you can't see it talking this old religious bullshit. Religious bullshit. You want to see some pornography? You think your children are safe with that Bible you give them? Hustler magazine is pure than the Bible, because Hustler magazine ain't never read no story about a king called David. Looked across the balcony and saw this naked woman sent for, had sex with her, got her pregnant. It's in the Bible. And then sent for her husband, who's down on the north flank fighting his war. Bring him back so they can blame it on him. Him and her. David. And the husband was so pure, says, no, I don't want to pleasure my wife while my men's on the front line dying. So when David found out he didn't have, he killed. That's in the Bible. In the Bible. But y'all don't know that, because you all cut yourself a piece of the bullshit that you can be covered with. You can't be covered. If you got a child that's 2 months old, you don't need me to take a message to your child. The universal God that put the whole universe together needs some church to take a message for me? Something ain't right. Something ain't right. And so here's where we are. And all you got to do is look. The reason the Japanese have China feared, for China got so much big money. But they don't have a white mentality. So when the Chinese was being laughed at by ignorant Americans, and when I was born, all you saw was Fu Manchu, Charlie Chan, And then the Korean War hit. And you white, 19 years old, out of Brooklyn, you get captured, and a 19-year-old Chinese captain speak better English than you do, know more about Brooklyn than you do. And your brain collapsed. That's why they made a deal. First, the white folks tried to get around it. Well, when you have to do your homework on this. When the war was over, the first time we ever went to war that a soldier didn't want to be repatriated, they stayed. Then America had to figure it out. Said, well, they couldn't escape because they didn't look Asian. We was fighting the Japanese, they tried to escape. Did they look Asian? See, when white folk can't figure it out, then they should stop. There ain't no hatred. Dr. King, don't care what you white folk think in America. A billion years from now, they'll know who King is. When he was killed, he was one of the most hated men in the world. Today, he's one of the most beloved men in the world. What did he do? He took on the mightiest nation in the history of the planet and brought this wench down to her knees with just a smile, with love. I knew him. Just a smile. Love. He didn't say one thing. And when the cameras was off, say something else. He didn't come on a radio show like this and talk about love and then change it. No, that was King. And all y'all. You look at your children. I look at white folks in the park hugging their children, and little thugs grow up to kill people all over the world. Y'all ain't even aware of it. But you're so lovable over your children. And so when you stop and think about it, the number one cancer victims in America are vegetarians, which is 90% white folks. Why? Because a black man named George Washington Carver invented soy for the military to make plastic with. You weren't supposed to eat it. That's how the universe worked. Now, if you'd have gone to Dr. Carver, he'd have spared you. No, not here. Y'all got these niggas y'all can make like you. No, no, no. You can't mess with God. And here's what happened. Henry Ford and Carver was like this. Henry Ford did not become great for him and his brother making an automobile. They stole the automobile from the Duray brothers out of Massachusetts. They ain't invented nothing like a car. All over the world, they say they invented the plant. That's all. Where'd it come from? This black man. When he went to Tuskegee, he'd never been around black folks. He's just like, y'all sitting, you look at the ice hockey. That was invented by runaway slaves in Canada. Huh? And then a boy named Richard Stanley came and watched it, then it became the Stanley Cup. Y'all don't even know you gangsters and thugs. Huh? Now watch this here now. The biggest TV audience on the planet is the Oscar night. Have you ever wondered why you don't know nothing but where this thing came from? What's it named after? You ever thought about that? Oscar? Huh? A black man, two brothers, Oscar Michelle, invented the movies. Why you think the statue looks like me, not like you? This is about. If I hate you, man, and hate you and punish you and rape your wife and your daughter, you think I'm going to make something for you to make your life better? Are you white folks and ignorant black folks and ignorant white folks stupid enough to believe that some rich white boy invented the cotton gin? Only the people that's suffering invent something. And then we go to federal court because there was a lawsuit. Eli Whitney, mother and father's rich in Connecticut, came down to visit their rich partners. In Virginia, and they saw these niggas in the field with the little boxes. The little boxes. He went back, put a patent on them. Okay. So you can go to federal court. And the woman there, who's former, she won the case. That's what this is about. One of the greatest books that's ever been out. I'm not saying great, I'm talking about selling. Harry Potter, you really believe some ignorant white woman living in a shelter on welfare wrote that? It's a game. And when people was out there telling the world, like me and a whole bunch of other people, nobody really got it till all them children started falling dead in the movies in Japan. And we knew about mind control. That's what this is about. You can't feel nothing except the white folks. That ain't got that evilness. You didn't pick it up from your mom and your dad. So I've hired, I went to get one scientist. See, that's the blessing you get. When they cut off the food stamps in Mississippi, because we was trying to get Negroes to register, it was Kennedy that did that. So I said, don't worry about it. So I flew in 70 tons of food every 2 weeks. I didn't have to ask nobody nothing. And America got so embarrassed, they restored it. Restored it. They gave me the worst form of cancer you could have. So I just told my son, the doctor said, don't show this to your mother. She a little flaky. Till after your sister get there. Then I showed it to her. How could they do that to you? I said, you think I'm leaving this booty back here and all my money and property to your high school sweetheart? You better get out here and come back in here with a different move on your face. I'm getting out this house. I said, oh. Ball up your fist like this. And I said, Queen Elizabeth was sitting next and she had her fist balled up. She make $360 million every 24 hours. The same universe that made her hand made your hand. See, God made women. Men made queens. God made men and men make kings. The difference between a woman and a queen and a man is the way you wrap the gift. Hmm. So I can meet a lady tonight at the fair. Said, oh, I love you. Tomorrow, I'm going to stay extra to improve it. So I go to Target and get her about $100 worth of filth. But on the way back, I stop at Fact Fifth Avenue and say, would you change the labels in this? Change the labels. Go by Neiman Marks and say, would you wrap this? See, if you don't know quality, I don't know diamonds. So if I wanted to buy $30 million worth of diamond, I'd find me a diamond person. And all these folks now are saying, we saving our money. Now the bank's going to fold. So what do? They're getting diamonds, silver, and gold. But when it's chaos, you can't run with it. It's 1 carat white diamonds. That's how big and that Cubans came over here. That's how they got over here. And black folks, you white folks can't see it. Cuba is 92% dark Cubans and not one dark Cuban in the government. He's a filthy bunch of bullshit. Works for us. The most secret Navy base in the world is Guantanamo. Would you put a secret base next to your enemy? It's a game. White folks said, why you niggas talk such bad English? I said, well, I can't speak for the rest of the niggas, but I don't speak for me. I learned my English from ignorant speaking white folks. When I got off that boat, I wasn't speaking nothing but pure Swahili, boss, until you say, go yonder and get that bell cotton, bring it over here. And I've been talking like you ever since. You can't even see it. Oh, you niggas look like gorillas. Oh, come on, man. Y'all got a zoo here?
We do.
Come to the zoo and look at the gorilla. And look at me. How tall are you, brother? 5'11". Okay, now watch this here. I'm 5'9". Watch this here. Now stand next to me. Here, see here? He's taller than me. My legs come up to his titty nipple. Black folks got long legs and short bodies. White folks have short legs and long bodies. Go look at a gorilla. If we got naked right now, who you think got hair on everybody? Him or me? Where's the gorilla here? I don't have hell like him and the gorilla guy. And then look at the gorilla's lips. They thin as razor blades. That's you looking at. But you so messed up, you want to see it's me. Thank you. See how it works?
Mr. Gregory, in that bit there, one of the most important things I think you talked about a little bit was your cancer diagnosis.
Yeah.
Much more to that. Can you tell us about that and what happened?
No, it was simple. I got on Joe Madison's show, black friend of mine, and told him about a little prayer I said. And I said, hey, God, I don't know where you are, but I know you're there. I said, I don't have to tell you I got cancer because you can't be responsible for the whole universe and don't know what I got. And I said, there's a lot of niggas that deserve cancer, but I'm not one of them. Now, if you're tired and need me, you write 12 niggas' names down. And you white folks over there upset over the word nigga. You invented it. And you black folks is upset. Let me tell you how stupid you are. If I called you a nigga, you'd be upset. If I called you a billionaire, you wouldn't. You ain't going to be neither way. You can't be a nigga and you can't be a billionaire. Why you always reach for the negative? You'll never be a billionaire, and you can't be a nigga. But you just took some stuff that, and so consequently, when you stop and think about, so I said, hey, God, I'll make a deal with you. I will not only give you 12 names of some black folks that deserve cancer. And if you need some close to the house, I can pick some of them out too. And then at that point, what he's talking about, I looked up around, I don't know where God is. And I talked to cancer. Mr. Counselor, I don't know you. I don't know what you look like. I ain't never seen you. But the scientists, my son, said you in my body. I'm giving you 72 hours to get out or I will roll on you. So, 3 days later, 72 hours, Joe Madison on his show was saying what Dick Gregory said. 5 hours later, I get a call. Dr. Krishna, Dick Gregory, yeah. I heard Joe Madison said there's some water we got you can drink. And anything in your body, anything in your body, in 5 days it'll be gone. Water. Is that hard to believe? I said, no, man. I teach my grandchildren about steam engines. It'll make a boat run all the way around the world. Water is that powerful. Not gasoline. Steam engine. And then after that, I got rid of it. This is a Tesla watch, the one that made the car. This watch here. That little thing there. Whatever you have in your body, it'll take it out, and whatever you haven't got, it can never get in there. That's this here. That's what this is. What? Okay. Tesla.
Amazing.
Okay. You see the word Philstein?
I do.
That's the Vatican. They license it. Just a punch up Philstein. And you see. This is what this is. It's a white folks. You walking away from the most brilliant minds on the planet, black folks. And we got all the secrets. And the reason we got them, because we never kill you. Now, you got the Filipinos where y'all went over there and screwed in the butt, in the mouth, and then stupid enough to bring them and put them in your hospital because you think they'd be like niggas. And every X amount of years, you read where they arrest one of them nurses, and they can kill 500 white folks. They kill more than that. They just don't want to scare you. That's what this is about. Huh? That's what this is about. There's a universal God that ain't never made a mistake and put your thumbnail where your eyelashes should be. Never made your nose and made a mistake and put it on the bottom of your feet. And you're not even clowning with me like I care. So this is the story you was asking for. Then I started doing the research and I found out that there's a doctor in Italy, you can Google it, that can cure any form of cancer you got with baking soda as long as it's not the one with aluminum in it. Any kind. And so this is the planet we live in, but you can't find it being full of hatred. I said to my wife, I said, baby, I was just having some sex and you got pregnant, so you in love. I said, if you want this to last, because I don't care, then it's not about love, it's can you be lovable? And I'm safe with you, you safe with me. 56 years later, she's still there. And I'm still there. You have any children? You have any?
I don't.
You around any people who have it?
Mm-hmm.
What the mother had for a child is nothing to do with sex. You hear me? It's lovable. Nothing to do with sex. And so all the knowledge black folks have, and we ain't mafiosa. The number one, and you chumps out there need to Google this and let white folks tell you, the number one drugged out state as we sit here now is Utah. Ain't no niggas out there. Most of them educated. They become religious in the womb. And when I go out there and interview first responders, they say we could have saved more of them, but it's something about the Mormon mentality. They won't let us in the house until they clean up the drug mess. Now, let me tell you this here. At night, when you get ready to go to sleep, rock-a-bye baby in the treetop. Now, that don't put you to sleep. Your brain tells your heart to keep beating while you sleep. That ain't gonna happen. Now, look at the white children. We sit here today. Now, 81% of everybody in America died from a drug overdiction is white folks. Y'all so busy blaming the civil niggas. Now watch this here. 91% of those white folks that die It happens after midnight. Why? Because the part of the brain that tells your heart to keep beating, this new drug they put on white folks, wipes that part of the brain out so the heart don't get the message. That's what you're dealing with. Mm. Oh, I know y'all wish y'all was dealing with some niggas. No. And so that's what this is about.
Mr. Gregory, we told the audience yesterday when we spoke, we were going to talk about two things, so I want to make sure to get to those. 1.5 million black men have disappeared. Everybody Googled it, I would imagine. New York Times story. You said you'd give us the answer.
The answer.
Where they went.
They're on that planet. You remember the planet this past, last June, that says our cousin planet? They found water. That's where they are. That's where they are. They're taking them every day. And let me tell the audience to do something, and maybe we can clear up something. Google, in 1950, the CIA went to a little village outside of Paris and put a certain type of drugs into the bread that the people eat. And it make them do violent things. You see it. Make them jump off mountains thinking they're a plane and all kind of stuff. And then you ask yourself when you read it, if they had that then, what you think they got now that they can put in our air and in our water and make us do things. And you and my mama are stupid enough to believe that's me. It's not. But it's coming to your house next.
The other thing we talked about was the Republican convention next week right here in Ohio. You have one of the greatest staffs, investigative staffs in the world. What's going to happen next week?
I pulled them all out. They come out. They come out 2 days before because it looked like this is where they're going to trigger it. Look like they, you know. See, if you write this down, if you Google, anybody got a machine? Can you Google something for me? If you Google President Obama's executive order, 13, 60, did it come up? Can you, okay. What's it say? So they can hear you.
Yeah, let's.
No, can you
hear? Come over here. Yeah, I'll let you hold the mic.
Executive order 13603, Obama authorizes slave labor. Let me get the rest of it here. Slave labor, and authorize the president to enact slave labor.
Okay, now hold it right there. Executive order, once it's signed, it become law in 90 days. He signed that in 2012. Okay, now here this good now. That's a law. This nigga y'all don't like, you will like him. Now, once we get martial law, there'll be no election. He becomes president then. Again and again and again.
Okay? Yeah, I heard about that, yeah.
Huh?
I heard about that.
Yeah, now watch this here. Watch this here. There's 115 cities in America where cops don't have no bullets. There are none. Now just Google that. Google that.
What should I Google exactly?
115 cities where police don't have no bullets because Homeland Security bought them all up. And they can't talk about it because people go out and rob and rape and do all that. You see it come up in a minute. 115 cities. Then I'm going to give you the shocker. Hmm? Anything come up yet?
Again, we're chatting with Dick Gregory.
It's a little slow here, so bear with me. I have the LTE on. 115 police officers, 140 police issue bullets, 60 police vehicles.
What did he say?
That's a different story.
Okay, no. What did that say that you read?
One second here. Just 115 police officers, 140 police issue bullets, 60 police vehicles.
No, that's not it.
This is a different story.
Yeah, punch up 118 cities in America where cops can't find bullets.
Okay, let's pull that
up.
Let me pull that up here.
And then the last one I'll give you.
Yeah, just bear with me. The LTE no, take your time. Is a little bit slow.
Take your time. Take your time. And don't know you white folks I'm talking to commit suicide. Truth ain't supposed to make you do that.
Yeah, just the internet here is just not really cooperating. It's on LTE, but it's running really slow.
Okay, so those of you out there, now here's the last one. The state of Indiana. See if you can pull this up. State of Indiana. Stand your ground law. It's the only state in America to have a stand your ground law against cops. And they talk about running that punk as vice president. When I go to Indiana and interview cops, they don't even know what's on the book. It means if you in your house or a cop bang on this door now.
We got that.
You got it. Okay, go ahead.
Indiana is one of the states that adheres to the controversial stand your ground law. It wasn't always that way, though. Originally, there was the Castle Doctrine. Under the Castle Doctrine, a person who is being threatened must retreat from the threat as much as possible before responding in self-defense. Date there is October 19th of 2015.
Okay. That means that all cops in the state of Indiana, if you sleep in your car and they hit on your window, you can kill them and you come under that law. Well, white folks think they got a nigger to play with. You better check it out. University of Mississippi, you can't get no dumber than folk come out of there. All over the world. Mississippi, if your brother got a PhD in medicine from Ole Miss and you got one from Harvard, yours is recognized all over the world. His is not. Y'all tolerate that.
So next, where we sit, just a few days away, that could be the start of what we're heading into with President Obama and the Executive Order 13603.
Yeah, and maybe that's what they heard on your show.
Yeah.
Enough people could call.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, and it's interesting because we talked a little bit about this yesterday, but as far as the Democrats go, that'll be the Republican convention, you know, they talk about Bernie Sanders, who I think is going to endorse Hillary this week, talks about he's not corporate, he doesn't have
any... Wait a minute. All his money's funneled through the ice cream.
Ben and Jerry's. Uh-huh. Exactly. When they sent a surrogate on during the Ohio primary, it was Ben from Ben and Jerry's.
Yeah. You know. So white folks, you have to pay a hell of a price messing with black folks. Get a good look at your baby. Get a good look at that dog you like. Because all of them going to be affected by it. Now, I know there's some black people. If I'd have been like I used to be, I'd be on the roof with a monocular watching y'all get slaughtered and laughing my ass off, but I knew it was going to happen to me, too. And I deserve it. And so, again, I say thanks to you. I don't know him, but I won't be safe if I'd hang around him. I can see it in his face. There's certain things that pass over you. When God said to the Jews, I'm coming tonight, put the blood on the door. And those Jews said, wait a minute, you made everything. But if I don't put in the blood, you don't know it's a Jew in there. He said, no, there's something on your face. And when I come by, if I see it, I'll pass you. And I see it on here. So just keep it. Don't get scared. Fear and God don't occupy the same spot. And ain't no way you can run. Ain't no way you can hide. But if y'all remember when you was little children, because after you get old, you're too stupid to pick up stuff. A big storm come through your area, trees is down, rooftops over, the spider web is still there intact.
The spider web.
Before we part ways, Mr. Gregory, I want to do this. The first time we met was at the Kent State reunion.
Mm-hmm.
And you got up and gave one of the most tremendous, interesting speeches that day.
Was that the one about the new niggas?
It was. But the thing about in that speech that you spoke about that I want to relay as we close this interview down, if you would, is a hit was put out on you. cover it in the papers, J. Edgar Hoover,
yeah,
if you could tell us that story.
Well, he dead for me.
That's true.
He sent the hit to Agent Johnson, who ran the Chicago Bureau. I had to tell X. Four Johnson had it. I went down to see Tony Accardo, and I said, if you love your mama and your children, there are some niggas you can mess with and there's some you can't. I'm one of the niggas you can't mess with. That's simple. Now, you can act a fool if you want. I don't do that. I don't have the power to do it. If I had the power to kill somebody, I'd have killed that dude that took the girl I wanted to take to the prom. I don't have no power. God, no, don't give me no power. I'm sure. We say thank you. Thank y'all for coming out. And y'all listen to this show. If you come see my show, if you hear something you don't like, just go home, keep your mouth shut, and I'll be back and let them white folk come out and hear the same thing you had and suffer like you did. Don't tell them. But about 85% of my audience around the world is white. They feel the same way, but they hear the truth, but they don't feel no bitterness. And they just load up. You can't believe. I was outside of Garland, Texas, when the governor said, nobody come out the house. We turned 10,000 people away that night for the first show. They could feel they'd be safe. I don't have the power to do it. And so again, I just say thank you all and keep doing what you're doing. Because somewhere the truth gets through.
There, we cannot thank Dick Gregory enough for being on the program. He is one of a kind, and there are two things I know in this world. Number one, you learned something today. And number two, there is nobody like Dick Gregory. We won't soon see his like around this way again.
Well, you know what the God say, run to a customer. You don't deserve